2008, you hung your boots up. What inspired you to write your book?
Probably my dad, I suppose. He passed away shortly after I retired in 2009, and he always wanted me to put the record straight on certain things, and probably just to tell my story. So I guess it was just just to stay true to him, and I'm glad I did it. It's been a nice experience.
And what can you say represent the things such as what?
Well, obviously a few of the injury stories, that sort of thing, will come out, and. The way things were done at certain times in my career, I've always been pretty quiet and just carried on and played my football. So I thought this would be the right time to it's a nice thing for myself to do, and after it was not a bad career, to have it down in writing, was always thought it would be a nice thing.
Unfortunately, you didn't get the names to sing it. Yep. That must be a really frustrating time for you as well. And you were still sympathetic for people like Owen Hargreaves as well, it seems to go through the same thing.
Yeah, well, I mean, I think, lots of players have suffered more, and I think, obviously, that, it's not the nicest way to be remembered, I suppose. So, to put the record straight is nice, and, most people are pretty complimentary about the way I played the game. Maybe they just felt I had too many injuries.
I'd say more than complimentary. I mean, to any Tottenham fan, there's been some classics for the Genoa's league. You're in there with Lineker, and you're in there with Gascoigne. You know, you're there. You must feel very proud of your Tottenham career.
Yeah, very proud. Tottenham people, Tottenham fans, the club have always been fantastic to me throughout my time there. It ended, possibly not in the right way, but I'll always look back with many, many more happy memories than bad.
You started your career at Portsmouth, didn't you?
Yeah.
And was it Jerry Francis who signed you to Tottenham?
Terry Venables. Which is obviously top man, and that's nice in itself, and he did the forward for me, gave me my England debut, so I was fortunate to play for many, many good players, but also some very good managers.
You did. I mean, talking about those good players, what was it like to play alongside people like Lineker and Gascoigne?
Well, Gazza was the one that I looked up to possibly the most growing up, as I became a teenager, I suppose, in the 90 World Cup, and then where he was just possibly the best player in the world, and then 4 years later I made my debut alongside him for England, so that was obviously one of the highlights, and it's a shame to see what's happening to him at the moment, but fingers crossed that he'll be okay.
And Euro 96 must have been a highlight for you,
that would have been nice. It was more of a highlight if it had gone in, but to play in that and to be involved in a huge tournament, it's only happened once before in the World Cup, and then Euro 96 in our own country was amazing to be part of. The fans got behind us like you could not believe. Before every game, football's coming home. Just so many good memories.
You left Spurs and you went to Wolves and a couple of other clubs, like ending up at Bournemouth. Did you ever think about whether you're going into coaching or managing, or is that something you want for the future?
No, nothing. I've never wanted to. I went up to Birmingham and then Wolves and then Bournemouth, I suppose, and very enjoyable, especially Birmingham and Bournemouth. And then the coach is something I've never done my badges, not interested in doing it one little bit.
So what's next for you?
Possibly a little bit of media, that sort of thing. I always said I want to travel the world when my career finished. Unfortunately, my dad's passing hit me pretty tough, and I'm looking to do that a little bit at the moment, and a few business projects with property. I don't feel so young, but I guess hopefully you're right.
You played your peak of your career was when football was really starting to accelerate, when the crowd started coming. How is the game different today than it was then, say, about 12 years ago?
Well, I started at Tottenham at the start of the Premier League, so I guess I was there right for the initial explosion, I suppose. And now it's obviously gone, tenfold even more so. I actually think the game has actually just become more physical and more about, I guess, athletes than players, people being able to pass the ball. So it's apart from the top five or six, I think it can be a little bit, a little bit headless, I suppose, at times. But I think the top teams are fantastic at the moment, and it shows with how we do in the European Champions League every year.
Well,
it can go either way. I think, of course, it stops the young players coming through, which will affect England as it did, you know, after the summer of the World Cup. But, you know, we all want that to get back on track, and I suppose the things that are happening at clubs like Manchester City aren't going to help that. But it will be better for the Premier League. The Premier League will only get better. So it's a double-edged sword, really.
What's on the Sunday morning, the Saturday evening, who's
going to go for first? Tottenham. always Tottenham, and then all my other teams, and including Southampton as well, because that's where I was from.
And every time I go to Tottenham, I always see a host of ex-Tottenham players.
I've been quite a bit recently. I did a book signing there a few weeks ago, and I'll be back there in a few weeks. It's nice going back there, but at the same time, I wish I was still playing.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Cheers.